New tonight, we are learning more about the latest deadly shooting involving Albuquerque police.
This started Saturday when a woman called 911 from a home along Coyote Canyon Place Northwest, that's near Ventana Ranch, saying her husband was threatening her and their children with a gun. Our team coverage begins with KOAT Action 7 News reporter Megan Cruz, who was there when police released new information tonight.
It was an hours-long standoff yesterday that had a deadly conclusion. At a press conference tonight, Albuquerque police gave us a lot of new details. They say the man fired shots at officers and at nearby homes, creating a dangerous situation for officers and the entire neighborhood. This is part of the 911 call that brought police to a Northwest Albuquerque home Saturday afternoon. The woman told police she and her two kids were able to get out of the home safely, but her husband, 50-year-old Armand Martin, was still inside. Albuquerque police officers showed up. One was certified in crisis intervention.
One of the children showed officers a cell phone video of their father yelling and what appeared to be the father chambering a round in a handgun.
Deputy Chief Eric Garcia says the department decided to call in its SWAT team along with a crisis negotiation team and a department psychologist. Garcia says Martin refused to come out or talk to negotiators.
He was basically playing the stereo or TV really loud.
Garcia says there was very little interaction between police and Martin for the next 3 hours. During that time, investigators tried to research his past. Previous police reports showed a history of suicide attempts. They also learned that Martin was a veteran who'd been treated at the VA hospital.
The department psychologist attempted to gather information from the VA, who confirmed a mental health history, but the hospital refused to provide any additional information about the suspect or his mental health history.
At around 5:30, officers say they heard gunshots inside the home.
This is a photo of the upper area of the home, where several more casings were located.
Police say they launched tear gas canisters into the home, breaking these windows. Then, about an hour later, police say Martin came out of his front door and fired shots from two handguns.
One APD officer discharged his department-issued rifle, firing a single shot.
Did he say, "Hey, I'm coming out," or did he just come out all of a sudden with two guns?
I don't have that information at this time, but I believe it was spontaneous. They weren't anticipating it.
Investigators say these two guns were found next to Martin's body. Dozens of officer-involved shootings in the past few years have put the department under intense scrutiny. They prompted an investigation by the U.S. Department of Justice. But in the early stages of this investigation, Albuquerque police believe
we did a lot of good things here. We got to understand, this is a subject who is actively firing a firearm into the neighborhood and inside his residence. He's a danger to the community.
Albuquerque police say the officer who fired his gun was part of the SWAT team. This is his first officer-involved shooting in the 12 years he's been with the department. Officials plan to release his name once he's been interviewed about the shooting. He's on standard paid leave tonight.
Albuquerque police lapel video is available from the shooting, and they expect to release that to the media in a couple of days.